Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Stir up in your church, we pray, O Lord, the spirit that fills St. Josaphat as he laid down his life for the sheep, so that through his intercession, we too may be strengthened by the same spirit and not be afraid to lay down our life for others. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all, and through all, and in all. But grace was given to each of us according to the measure of Christ's gift. And he gave some as apostles, others as prophets, others as evangelists, others as pastors and teachers, to equip the holy ones for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until we all attain to the unity of faith and knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the extent of the full stature of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord, and meditates on his law day and night.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does, prospers.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Alleluia! 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 Alleluia!
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Holy Father, I pray not only for these, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, so that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you, that they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as you are one, I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me, and that you love them even as you love me. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known that the love with which you love me may be in them and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When we hear this type of gospel, we know it comes from the collection of gospels according to St. John, don't we? You could just hear it in the voice of John and his community that has gathered around him, who wrote this. And how beautiful it is written, a theological text. A text that allows us to dive in deeper to the mystery of the unity between Christ and the Father. You know, we often talk about this oneness, and it's important to understand the oneness. And we should just pass it aside as that's kind of nice, but it's really central to the faith. The oneness that Jesus has with the Father. The oneness that the persons of the Trinity are together, united. One God, three divine persons. That unity of personhood in the Blessed Trinity is central to the faith. It's just not a nice teaching or doctrine. It is central to the faith. The oneness, the one church that Christ founded. You could see how when there is not a oneness, there's a fracture. There's an upsetment to the will of Christ. The scandal of Christianity is that we're fractured. We're not sitting at the one table. And that's what we always have to pray for. And that's what Jesus is praying for here in the Gospel of St. John, this priestly prayer at the Last Supper. That they may be one as you and I are one, Father. The unity in the church. So why did Christ find the church? Why did he establish it? He knew it was not going to be easy. But he founded the church upon the faith of St. Peter. Who do people say that I am? We just heard that gospel when we celebrated the wonderful memorial of St. Leo the Great. How beautiful this gospel text of this priestly prayer of Jesus as we look to the life of Josaphat, a bishop of the Eastern Church, a unifier that the church can breathe with both lungs of the East and the West, and pronouncing the truth of the unity that is among the Christians who profess the one faith. My brothers and sisters, may you and I yearn for that oneness with God. May you and I always yearn that people together, God's family, are in union with him, not only in their believing that he exists, but that we
deposit of faith together, that there's no fraction among us when it comes to the teaching of the scriptures, the explanation of these scriptures, how they are to be lived, and the dogma and doctrine they contain for our salvation. Because when we're not together, we're scattered. I pray that they be one as you are in me and I in you, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me and that you love them even as you loved me. The whole purpose of Christ's coming, his birth, his public ministry, his passion, death, resurrection, descent of the Holy Spirit, and the founding of the church upon the confession of St. Peter is for our salvation. It's for our salvation. And when any time that is disrupted or fractured or separated, the body becomes weak. St. Josaphat worked tirelessly, and even by the shedding of his blood, for the unity of the church. Because he knew if it was fractured and separated, the body of Christ will become weakened. And many people will not hold together what has been handed down from Christ to the apostles to the present day. That's why it's always important that we understand the oneness. One church, one priesthood, one baptism, one God and Father. And all of us dive into that mystery by allowing ourselves to be truly united in the deposit of faith. I'm going to pray the opening antiphon once more, because as I was hearing that opening antiphon, I just thought, how beautiful that sets the tone for the morning's liturgy. Because of the Lord's covenant and the ancestral laws, the saints of God persevered in loving brotherhood. For there was only always one spirit in them and one faith. As we were praying that, as I was coming to the altar, I felt how powerful a statement. I was getting so excited as I was reading it, I was stumbling over even the words. Did you notice I was stumbling over the words? I do know how to read, but I just was stumbling over the words because it just means so much to me as I was hearing it, because I'm paying attention to everything that's going on. And I'm listening intently of words and prayers. Because of the Lord's covenant and the ancestral laws, the saints of God persevered in loving brotherhood, for there was always one spirit in them and one faith. I hope we can get back to that. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and complete trust.
Through the guidance of the Holy Spirit and the Church's public witness and commitment to ending racism, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government officials, may the Holy Spirit guide them in discerning actions that best serve the common May the Lord continue to nurture their faith and draw them closer to himself. Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they find eternal rest with God in heaven. Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Anthony San Martino, Steve and Anita Sager, Angelina Schneidinger, and all those on our prayer list, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Christine Karankiewicz, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like St. Josaphat did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, that through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, that through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Christ, presented brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Most merciful God, pour out your blessing upon these offerings and confirm us in the faith that St. Joseph had professed by the shedding of his blood. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr Josaphat, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness to Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, He took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world.
sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
Thank you. And do thou, O Prince